Yes, I see a convergence. A convergence which is related to the fact that there is the mass of data is increasing. So the more data you get, the more you need also to prepare on how you use this data, the analytics, how you sell it in the end to the end user. And so this makes some convergence in the industry. You have also seen a very strong push on cloud-based solutions. Everybody is putting the data on the cloud. We do as well. All our data is going on the cloud, and which makes it then available to run analytics. And here, we will run our own, but obviously we can really get benefits from the rest of the industry playing with the data and making something even more valuable out of it. First of all, we will continue to push very strongly around agriculture, deforestation, maritime surveillance, some governmental applications as well. But this is more the classical extension of what we do today. We will for sure look at again at oil and gas. I think there will be a time when the industry will also recover and look for additional growth. We will try to help them there. And I'm very interested by the financial sector as well, which seems to awaken to the geospatial data and to see more and more use for it. It's an evolving market in terms of pricing and way you channel the data to the customers. Today there is still a lot of subscriptions, I would call it this way, credit agreements that you get with long-term customers. I think this will continue to be the case, especially on the governmental and civil governmental side. You need this long planning and kind of security on the data access. At the same time, we definitely have to change also and to adapt to new industries, to new players, which are much more commercial, which are looking for a very large amount of data, but at sometimes lower prices on specific areas. So we are adapting to this, and obviously you will see in the next year that our offers will adapt to these different segments of customers. Airbus is very collaborative and has always been. I think it's part of the DNA. We are partnering even at the satellite infrastructure level. We have partners in Kazakhstan, in Azerbaijan, in Asia, which brought their satellites, their resources to our infrastructure. So this is something we do. We have partnerships, very, very strong partnerships on the value-added services, where we partner with people who know for agriculture specific crops. Or specific users. We partner with NGOs and we partner obviously also with some customers. I will just mention one example. We have just launched the Starling Deforestation Index, which we had developed together with a partner being Nestlé and the NGO being TFT. I think this is a great example of what you can do with different brains, different backgrounds. In the geospatial world. From the space side, I think we have a great heritage, great brains and great resources. When it comes to the software development, new algorithms, artificial intelligence, machine learning, the issue there is that there are plenty of industries who need exactly the same capabilities. So here the resources are scarce. There are some great people working with us. These people which we take from the IT background, from the software industry and involved into our projects, they need some time to get sure to get trained, to understand some specifics of our industry. But these are very clever people, they learn very fast, and I found it very refreshing to get them on board. They bring lots of new ideas and lots of value to the industry.